Hi. Hello. How you doing? All right, lots of friend drama thus far in Libra season. Let's see what you guys have. You guys definitely have friendship is pretty important for you guys, obviously. You have a lot of friends that you also have to like take care of or kind of baby because Aries in the 11th house. Yep. It's been coming up for everybody. All right, so that just kind of means that all these celebrations, this party, this Libra, party time isn't really serving our purpose right now. It's just a little more distracting. Maybe you're not getting invited to things. It's just like Virgo season was all about hard work, but here it's like you can't even enjoy this, like what you amassed from all that hard work. It's like it's not even I don't know. It's just not serving your purpose. Like maybe we didn't work so hard this Virgo season. Maybe it wasn't really earned. So you just can't party all the live long day and expect like every time to be super spectacular. You know what I mean? Like I always want that to happen, but I typically will like span my events out so like I have to work towards them, and they're a little more fulfilling that way. I feel like there's always more room for unique things to happen or stuff if they're not quite as often. So, but Libra doesn't want to do that. Libra just wants to day in, day out, have fun. Yeah, very playful. So, what else we got for Gemini? Okay. Knight of Pentacles. So, we're making some money. We're going in a new direction with the job. Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. We'll talk about those in a sec. But job is sending us in a new direction, you know? There's a purpose behind it. Maybe it's something that you feel like you need to do. To protect yourself or to protect whatever it is, knights are for protection. So there's something you feel like you have to do in reference to job or money. So whether that's giving some to somebody else, yeah, we'll see here. We'll see what's going on with this. And we got the Tower and the Nine of Wands, which both have been coming. Okay. Have to show that. Bottom of the deck. So the Tower and Nine of Wands. So that's really this Tower energy when that kicks in is just going to make you crumble. And you are going to get a little paranoid here with that Nine of Wands. You're going to be like looking behind your back. You're gonna be a little inside your head, like what the hell's going on? What's happening? You're just going to feel like you're in the position to lose a lot at the moment. You know what I mean? Because you have so many things that are kind of like calling your attention. So many responsibilities, and so we're gonna see some of those fall, hopefully. Because that can weigh you down when you have too much. And then the Lover steps in. That's awesome. That's you guys. And look what's right underneath it. Ten of Pentacles. So if I'm pulling cards, oh wow, you guys. Okay, if I'm pulling cards right after it, which I don't usually, but these just look so inviting to me. So Ten of Pentacles, very rich. It's going to be a very rich love. It's going to be one that demands that you completely and entirely change who you've been to this point. And Not necessarily that all of your wishes may come true, but they may in time. You know, it's going to be like this person just has it all going for them. Very creative energy. I'm going to leave these two out on the table. Got it all. Lots of success. Maybe you meet this person at an event, like a wedding or some kind of party, you know. And you realize that to be with that person, you really have to change who you've come to be. And it looks like you're open to that, which is great. It's great to see. Gemini is mutable, so obviously change is a really big factor. Change is something that is a daily thing for us. We're always looking to better ourselves and change the world and look at things from every perspective. Let's see what else, Gemini. All right. Now I see this associated with a lot of Virgos I know, or people that have Virgo energy. So look out for that. It's not necessarily a card that implicitly implies a Virgo, but somebody that does have the resources to give back and help, to be charitable. We see that she's giving three. Or half of what she's keeping basically away. So it's just a reminder, don't give more than you can at this present time. But if you can give, certainly take that opportunity and you'll feel very, very loving. You'll feel very well. Never mind. Never mind. Maybe somebody's going to take advantage of your giving nature. That's literally like the exact opposite card of that card. I mean, I just have to show you guys. So this here, she's giving those three there, and it's making her feel really good, really full, really loved or loving. And even nature is responding to that. Look at the bird that's come to her. And then we have Seven of Swords, which is somebody getting away with something. So it's like diametrically opposed forces right there. So I will strike what I just said. I would say probably hold on to what you have. You may feel like you want to give, but let's look a little further. Let's see what we get, because that Seven of Swords is a very cunning individual. They may be like trying to get you to commit to some kind of like contribution, like a charity or like an organization, and the funds aren't really going for what they are told or supposed to be going to, you know. If you sign up for something that's money related, it just seems like that investment is going to do you wrong really quickly. I mean, it was the next card, so this person could be taking from you. So let's see. Let's see what else. Gemini. Oh, yep. All right. They definitely have their hands in the pot. And they do not have good motives. So I'm going to say that this lover's energy is going to not be a positive thing. Yeah. it's not going to be positive. So the next thing that I just got was the Ten of Wands, so burden card. So we start off, looks great. Ooh, looks really lavish. Like we're just having the ball, you know, drinking the wine, having a good time. I could see myself changing with this person and really molding into a new thing, like really striving for something else, but it's not going to be easy, but I could see that happening. And then right after that, we go into, okay, they need something from me. Okay, they're going to take it from me, you know, like, okay, I could give a little more. And then they're just going to step in and take it from you. Maybe you're not even given the chance to give it. So that moves into the Death. So we see, like, maybe it's an affair that steps in and it quickly dissolves. You quickly feel cheated or that you're manipulated, and like it's just like you were deceived, you know, like they stepped in, stepped out, got what they wanted from you, and then you're left feeling like all of this weight, all of this stuff is on your shoulders. Maybe they've really made some chaos in your life that you now have to deal with. And the only positive thing I can say about that is that the Death card is upright. So that means that you will be able to transform through this. Where we saw Taurus with the Tower and the Death reverse, you guys are open to change. So even though this could be a whirlwind of like a romantic interest, it's going to leave you high and dry. Like you guys see there's possibility in bettering yourself through it. You're going to see something new that's going to help you move along on your path. So that can be rewarding in itself, even though this act or this drama is going to be a little surprising. It's going to kind of come out of nowhere. Let's see here. Okay, so King of Swords. So King of Swords is really the person that could be putting demands on you here after the Ten of Wands, a burden card, could be a very intelligent person. You know, if it's a counselor, it's somebody, but it's somebody that's using currently, at least, their intellect for harm or for, you know, not the right reasons. So look out for that. Look out for somebody that you know is really smart, but you don't always trust, and they don't seem very, you know, present all the time, that they're very flighty. So they come in and come out. They don't really stay around for a while. Maybe they have helped you in the past, but it doesn't look like they really have your best intentions. Maybe they're one of these things that are weighing you down. And if we're talking about it with the Chariot reversed, it could be that you guys don't know which direction you're headed in. You know, like you're open to changing, but you don't really have clarity of where to go, you know. This person could be a Cancer, could be a Scorpio, which you don't really see those as air signs, but oh, here we go. Speaking of air signs, the Star. So, gosh, Libra season really throws me off. I'll start saying one thing and then the completely opposite thing happens. So the Chariot, where are you headed? Where do you want to set your path or your future? Where's your future going? You know, maybe you don't feel like you have to physically move to get to your future, to get to where you're working towards. Interesting. Okay. Oops. So Ace of Wands reversed. There may be a new responsibility or a new call that's going to kind of distract you from your future here, and it's going to demand some of your attention. Or maybe it's a creative pursuit. You know, you may have like a book idea out of nowhere and you start doing it, but you quickly find out that it's just, it's not really a full-on idea. It was just like a quick thought. Maybe it was more of a tweet where you guys saw it as like a, you know, a blog. You know what I mean? It was a shortened version. So don't put all your eggs in that basket. Now we have here love again. We have commitment. We have a partnership. We are giving and receiving. So it's, you know, what do they say about love? It's a two-way street. Definitely in that card. I mean, that card is like the second sister card to like Gemini. You know, it's two and it's two people, and you still have those wings, like just like you see with on the lover card. And there's going to be a really big decision, a big agreement or disagreement with this person. It's going to be very, very big. You're not going to be able to not notice it when it happens, because it's going to call out for some major attention. And maybe you get this thing and you're running like full speed with the Ace of Wands, with this new site, this future vision or idea that you want to embark upon, and it involves another person, and it feels like you're both in it together, and you have to make this big lofty decision, and so it's really here with the Hierophant. This could certainly be a Taurus or some Aquarius energy, and it's really about knowing the real truth of it. You know, that's like a spiritual insight. So, I would think that it's good, whatever decision is made, but it's kind of hard to see. But it's going to be big, big, big. So whether it's a commitment, a relationship, like hitting the ground, running, let's see. I'm going to keep that out, but I'm not going to talk about it just yet. Let me get one other card about this decision, because that one's a big one. Okay, makes sense. So, the King of Swords is, it's like you know what you need to do, but now you're like all high and mighty, because you're like, well, I can make anything happen. I'm super intelligent, you know. I'm not going to let other people kind of control me or manipulate me. And then the Chariot is like, you just don't want to move. You know what I mean? It's like you physically... you don't want to change your home. You don't want to go off to another place. But you know that something's got to change for you to start investing in your future. And so you take the easy route. You get this little idea that just kind of comes out of nowhere. But it's not really serving your future purpose. You're just taking it as like a way to stay kind of put, but be doing something new, be doing something different. And if it's something that a friend or somebody offers you, like as a collaboration, you've got to either like invest some money, some big time, some kind of a decision, maybe a contract, you know, and it could certainly have to do with unlocking something bigger, but unfortunately, it's more show than it is tell. You know, it's like, it's not going to pay off. It's going to maybe not reveal exactly what you intended, or not come to fruition like you intended, because we have here the Five of Pentacles is going to step in, and it seems to be doing that for Libra season. because I think relationships, especially Libra relationships, can oftentimes be, since they're not, they don't plunge to the depths of the other person, they're what's presented in the mirror, what looks good on paper. You don't really know that person inside and out, and therefore you're not really getting what you need, because it's not a passionate love, like an intense, emotionally charged love, like a Taurus Scorpio. And so you are going to be forced to really consider moving at the end of it. It's like you're going to invest your time. I don't know. It's like a weird order that these cards came in. But there's definitely future planning is on the table. A lot of that's happening for you guys. Where are you going to go? It's just like you're a little apprehensive. And maybe it feels a little easier to make a decision with a partner. Or maybe have a roommate or something. Somebody going with you or that's in it with you. But it's like the investment or this person is going to maybe be asking more than what you can provide. And it's going to make you feel really upset. Maybe you can't make it work financially, whatever this agreement is. And so you're forced to have to kind of venture out on your own now. And it's just kind of wherever you want to go energy, but you're definitely unsure of the future. So it's like you wanted to jump at this opportunity to not be alone or something, but what's really at play here is for you to be working on yourself or for you to be transforming, and it's harder to do that when there's another person in the mix and when you're not open to physically moving. So but sometimes it's necessary. Sometimes you have to do that. You have to make the big leap. I just don't know. That Five of Pentacles is always scary when it comes up. So it's going to shake some things up towards the end of Libra season for you guys. I mean, Libra season throughout is going to be highs and lows, like for sure. Like you got the Tower, Death, Five of Pentacles, Ten of Swords, Chariot reverse. I mean, it's like you're not going to be able to fully celebrate or enjoy things. But there's a lot of good aspects to this too. So it's not just one direction, you know, it's like every direction, but it's a lot that's going to play out in a very short amount of time. If we're just talking about Libra season here, I mean, this is setting things up for future, but Libra season is this, and you guys move fast through things, so I guess that makes a little more sense that for a Gemini there would be a lot more bigger things, you know, that would happen. But certainly you could find a suitor, certainly. Maybe that's the person that's promising you a new future. But they're asking something big of you here. And it's like they're asking maybe for your devotion, the Hierophant. Maybe for your devotion. And it's almost like we got this right after the Hierophant, which is the spiritual leader. And then you see like the church window or whatever here, and we're completely ignoring it. So it's like maybe they asked a little too much of you guys, and you're just like, nope, you know, I guess I'm gonna have to do this by myself. I'm not sure, see how that plays out, but stay calm and collected. I know it's hard for you. I have Gemini in me, but yeah, just try to filter some of this if possible, but at least make some future strides. Maybe don't fully decide Libra season. Well, I don't know what judgment you may have to, but get to a better place.